Come on, Jamie. It'll be fun. I've seen two people jump. Last chance. Tomorrow I'm gone.
No way, I'm not jumping.
Go, Leo.
I guess that's it.
You'll come to visit, right?
See ya.
Bye.
Safe. You know I don't like them. It's only meanness out there.
Mom? Dad?
Do you know where my parents are? They have a farewell on campus.
They asked me to see if you wanted to have a bite to eat.
Yeah.
Well, I haven't got anything in the fridge.
We'll have to go down to Pete's.
Okay.
Pick a card.
What happened?
My dad cut me with a piece of glass.
By accident?
Here, wait, don't show me. Put it back.
Where is it? How'd you do that?
I gotta go. Sorry.
What's your name?
Bill, what's yours?
Leah.
Dad.
Need help?
No, I'm good.
Who is he? I saw him in the woods, talking crazy stuff to his dogs.
You just stay away from him. He's not right in the head.
Jumped off the cliff today. Took me 2 whole summers to finally do it.
Felt good?
Felt amazing. Stay here. Why do we have to move?
You're gonna be okay.
I just wish we could have at least stayed for the summer. But no, they're sending me off to summer camp out there. Ginger!
Leah! Have to go now.
We're expecting monthly written reports of your life down there.
Bye, Sam.
You take care of yourself now.
Night, Ginger.
I don't think that's fair. I don't think any of this is fair.
Please, Leon, not now. Let's just get through this last day without losing it.
I'm taking those records.
No, half of these are mine.
You use an iPod.
You really want to make me pay for all of it?
I'm taking the records.
You clearly know how to take advantage of the situation, so take them.
Hi, honey.
Salut, ma puce.
Dad, stop calling me that. It's embarrassing. I'm not 5 anymore.
We brought you some food from the party.
I'm not hungry.
Have you packed an overnight bag?
I don't want to go and live in stupid Houston.
You want to take a night swim?
No!
Bonjour, sleepyhead.
I didn't sleep.
The movers will be here any minute. Sam stopped by. He left you a present.
I overheard you and Mom talk yesterday.
It's complicated, Leah.
Are you getting a divorce?
No. No, we want to work things out. I want to work things out.
Is that why we're moving?
Have you packed all your knickknacks?
I gotta go, Dad. I forgot something really important. I'll put it in my suitcase. I'll be right back.
Leah! No trailing off today!
To Bill.
Never thought he'd have a scrawny little girlfriend like you.
I'm not his girlfriend.
What do you want from him?
He took something from me.
Well, scrawny. He was in here.
Okay, then.
You're looking for me?
Where's my ladder?
What ladder?
I know it was you.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Where is it? You're lying.
You want to hit me? Go ahead.
Get off me! Get off!
Give that to me.
I need my things. Where are you hiding the ladder?
I'm not joking.
Me neither.
Give it back!
Bill? Bill! Bill, please say something! Bill, I'll be right back. I'm gonna go get a rope. something! Bill! A deep shaft and he can't get out.
Who are you?
Where's my fucking gun, Molly?
Please come, he's hurt.
Just go, you're freaking me out.
Where is it?
I need your help, please!
Leah!
She overheard us last night.
Oh no. Do you think she's hiding? Why couldn't you keep your mouth shut?
Nora, don't jump to conclusions. I haven't told her anything. She asked me if we were splitting up. Really, Nora? Him? Now?
Are you out of your fucking mind? What does that change, huh?
Who cares?
You, obviously. Shit! I really didn't want her to find out. Not like this.
I told her we were trying to work things out.
Your version.
What's that supposed to mean?
When will you ever be able to face the facts? I don't want to be married to you anymore. Leah.
You're still here? I sent out the final notice 2 weeks ago.
I know.
It was also put on your door.
Can I get another month or two? I can't leave right now.
I'm selling the building next week. You know this since a couple of months. I have an inspection in 2 days.
I can't deal with this right now. I'm already late for work.
I'll drop off the moving boxes today. If you're not out by the weekend, I have to put a padlock on this door.
Hello, Ron.
Hello, Leon. Did I catch you at a bad time?
No, not at all.
I just wanted to thank you for sending me the book.
Oh, good, you got it.
Yeah, I look forward to reading it. I'm impressed by the fact that Leon translated it.
How is my daughter? She just canceled our dinner plans again.
I'm concerned, Leon. She's a lovely girl, don't get me wrong. She's very smart, too. She's been a real asset here. But lately, though, she's been distracted and seems to have lost all enthusiasm.
I'm sorry to hear that. Thanks for telling me. Have you talked to her about it?
No, not yet. I'm just not sure where to go from here. I don't have any more translations, and she's been late with a couple of revisions. Today, she hasn't even shown up.
Well, that surprises me. Listen, Ron, I'll check on her, okay? Thanks for calling.
Leah, what are you doing out here?
You ever notice how ugly the building is?
I've been texting and calling you.
I misplaced my phone.
Ron needs some corrections on the Lang novel. Did you get them done?
Almost.
Go see a doctor. You look awful.
Why don't you go back to therapy?
I've had enough therapy. I don't think the prescriptions are effective anymore.
Because you've been on it too long. Do you eat regularly? Drink enough water? Exercise? All this will help.
Continue with them then.
What about friends? Do you have any good friends that you can talk to?
I don't like to burden them.
Take a card.
Thank you.
Close call.
How long have I been here?
You came in yesterday.
Where's my stuff?
You had nothing on you. I need to check your info before the doctor discharges you.
Can I borrow a phone? I need to make a quick call.
Okay. I'll come back in a sec to get it.
Thanks.
Why? I went to one of them at Union Square Park. I didn't realize that. Hey, I know that guy. I'll meet you out front. Professor Chereau?
Danny, what a nice surprise. I hope you haven't given up on philosophy.
Oh, no, no, not at all. I've been studying your book. I carry this with me wherever I go.
Danny, we gotta go.
There you are. You look pale, ma puce.
Don't call me that, Dad. Thanks for the clothes.
What did the doctor say? They wouldn't tell me anything. What happened?
I just collapsed in a swimming pool.
Why?
I don't know. It's never happened before.
Are you taking your medication?
Sometimes. I have to turn these forms in. I'll meet you outside.
Do you know Maureen? She hasn't been to the city before. I took her to Boreham Hill. There was a new restaurant there.
Merci.
So, what do you think?
About what?
Coming upstairs with me.
No.
You haven't been listening to anything I said.
You have a reading at your old college, I know.
I think getting out of here for a day would do you good.
Dad, please, I can't.
Why?
Because I'm behind with work. I need to catch up. And I have to find a new apartment.
Leah, do you still like your work?
It's easy. Why?
Because Ron called me.
He called you?
He received my book. He thinks you've lost interest in your job. Have you? No, I don't know, I'm waiting. Hold on a minute.
Okay.
Huh?
I'll come.
Good! I'm so glad. Has changed. There's the bakery. Huh? There's the dentist. You remember Jamie's mom? She was your dentist. Are you still in touch with your old friend Jamie? Remember our old house?
I do, but I don't want to go back in time.
I wanted to bring you back here for so long. We had good times here. You are happy. were real free and happy. You were so happy that you didn't want to leave. You ran away on moving day. You remember? I still feel really bad about that. We should have told you we were moving to separate places in Houston. You got really sick. Worrisome sick. We didn't expect you to be that upset over our separation.
It's a pretty hasty move, I remember that.
Unfortunate circumstances.
Let's just get through this last day without losing it.
You both were always so secretive about what really happened here between the two of you.
Your mother had an affair, and he happened to be another professor. You know, it's a small town, Pierce. The talk. I just couldn't take it anymore.
But now it's all in the past. Hey, Dad. Why did you say I was running away? Where was I?
C'est pas. We couldn't find you. Sam couldn't either.
Well, what happened exactly? Who is that?
I already told you. Maureen. I've mentioned her to you a couple of times.
But what is she doing here now?
You told me that you didn't want to go to the reading, so I asked her to meet us here.
I could have taken the train.
I thought you might want to explore a bit on your own.
It's so gorgeous up here.
Maureen, Leah.
So nice to meet you. So, this is where you grew up?
She was a wild child. Tiens. This will prove it to you. I finally cleaned out the attic. And I found it. It was never my intention to hurt you. I love you, Lapus.
I hope to see you again soon.
Call me.
Watch out! You almost hit me!
Sorry.
Keep your eyes on the road, lady.
But I say unto you, love your enemies. Bless them that curse you. Do good to them that hate you. And pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you, that ye may be the children of your Father which is in heaven. For he maketh his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sendeth rain on the just and on the unjust.
Thank you, Molly. That was beautifully read.
Thanks.
Today I'd like us to talk about this last passage Molly just read.
Who are you?
For he maketh his sun to rise on the evil and on the good, and sendeth rain on the just and on the unjust. It's a beautiful passage. Thought.
I dreamt of a whale swimming out there. I found this for you. Thought you'd shape it into a turtle.
Yeah, I could work.
Thanks.
Sam? It's me. Leah.
What happened to you? Come in.
Our old house is for sale.
Couple from Montreal. They came for the summer, but they don't come no more. I take care of it for them. Tea?
Sure. How are you? How have you been?
I'm here. I've always been here.
I'm sorry for not getting in touch.
Why are you here?
I came with my dad, but he's gone. He's doing a reading of his book at his old college.
And you didn't go with him?
No. It's hot here.
Are you sick?
No, it's just for emergencies.
Why did you come, Leanne?
Dad gave me this photo album. It's a picture of you and me. Where is it? Here. Here it is.
Yeah.
Dad talked about happy times.
You don't remember?
I wanted to show you that.
You came to show me that photo?
Yeah. And I wanted to see you, but now I think I better get going.
Where are you going now?
Going back.
Back? Where's back?
Back to the city.
Well, you're not gonna make it back to the city like this. You're not gonna make it back to the
city. Yeah. I don't want to stay here.
You're a mess.
I can't talk anymore.
What's happened to you?
Here. Drink this.
What is it?
It'll get the chemicals out of your body.
What time is it?
It's a little after six. The sun's just coming up.
God, I can't sleep. You still carving things?
No. I gave that up years ago.
I remember. You gave me a whale the day we left. I hated saying goodbye to Ginger. I had the sentine stand. I mean, that was a hunting stand and I made it mine. Did you know that?
Of course. I remember.
Is it still there?
You want to go see?
Yeah, I'd like to.
The lady from Montreal left some nice things behind at the house. She told me I could take whatever I want. Here. This is a... here. See what fits.
Hid the ladder.
Leah, what is it?
I can't breathe.
Leah, put your head between your legs. Leah, look at me. Look at me. Stop sobbing. Focus. Breathe, Leah. Again? Breathe, for God's sake. Deep breaths. Good. I'm going to get you some water.
Bill, please say something.
Here, drink this. Thank you. What is it? Take it easy. What is it?
Oh God. I remember.
Remember what?
The day we left for Houston, I came here to get my things. But he had taken my ladder.
Who? Who, Jamie?
Oh, Bill. His name was Bill, and I followed him, and we had a fight up at the old abandoned mines, and I had a gun, and I shot him, and I killed him.
What are you talking about? No, you're just very upset.
No.
And you didn't want to leave here, and you made up some story so that you think your parents can take you away.
No, I remember. I went to your house, but you weren't there, and I got a rope and a flashlight from your shed.
No. You always had a wild imagination. You were hiding. You didn't want to leave, and your parents...
Sam, it happened!
Your parents called me!
No, you have to believe me! I ran back to the mines, but it was getting dark, and I couldn't see him. Then there was this scary man and a dog, and I freaked, and I left him there to die.
Listen, I don't know what happened to you after you left here, but these pills you're taking are making me crazy.
Oh, God, you don't believe me.
No, I don't believe you killed anybody.
Why would I make something like this up?
Where are you going now?
To the mine shaft.
No one disappeared there.
You don't believe me anyway.
Because it's not true. Because it's a fabrication of yours.
I need to know.
Well, I'm going with you.
It might not be him. He could have gotten out. Come on. Come on. Come on.
Why don't you go ahead? I'll be right behind you, all right?
I'll see you back in, 6 months or so? Bye.
Hi.
Sam! Hi! What a surprise.
Yeah, it's been a while now.
Yeah. Do you want to make an appointment?
No. I have a favor to ask.
Okay. What's that?
I found it. It's human, right?
Yeah, it looks like it. You should go to the police.
I will. I just need you to tell me the approximate age.
Sam, where did you find this?
Out in the woods.
Okay, I'll take a look at it, but you need to come back later.
I will.
Right.
How's Jamie?
Oh, he's good. Yeah, he got married.
Oh, good, good. I'll come back later.
Okay.
Check the local papers from June to August of the year we left.
I told you.
That doesn't prove anything, Sam.
What about his family? You remember anybody from his family?
I saw someone familiar yesterday. I think I saw his mother, but I'm not sure if it was her.
Where was that?
At the church.
Well, you gotta go find her.
I don't have the stomach for that.
She's gonna tell you that he's alive.
Can you imagine facing the person who might be responsible for killing your son?
I think she's gonna tell you he's alive. Come on, let's go home.
Hi.
Hello there.
This is a beautiful church.
I wouldn't want to be anywhere else.
I grew up here and passed it a million times, but I never came in.
What is it that brings you here now?
I'm looking for someone. I think her name is Molly and...
Molly McKenzie.
Yes. I'm actually looking for her son. Does he attend services here too?
No. Just Molly.
How can we be forgiven when we can't forgive ourselves?
He is all forgiving.
To have that kind of faith.
It lightens the burden.
Do you know where I could find Molly? Maybe an address or something? I'd like to write her a note.
Yeah. She is at 32 Lincoln Road.
Thanks.
Our doors are always open.
What can I do for you? My name's Leah.
Didn't we meet yesterday? Come in. Come in. Each other in church?
I knew your son.
Here they are, my kids. They're good kids. My kids, yeah.
Whew. Where are they now?
They're gone. They're both gone.
But alive, right?
They're all gone.
Gone where? Where is Bill now?
Maybe New York. We haven't talked for a long time.
So he's alive.
He better be. What is it you want from him?
I just want to get in contact with him. Maybe I can leave my phone number and address, and you can tell him I've been looking for him.
How do you know Billy? There's not a lot of people who come around here asking for him.
I'll leave the address of where I'm staying here as well, and I never get good phone service up here.
I'm gonna call him right now. Bill? Billy? My boy, it's me. Now there's someone here who's asking about you. What's your name again?
Leah.
Her name's... Oops.
Hello? Hello?
Bill? Billy? My boy, it's me. Yeah, there's somebody here is asking about you.
What happened? Who was that on the phone?
My mother.
Is she okay?
I'm not sure.
He's alive.
I told you.
I saw his mother.
And what did she say about him?
She wasn't coherent. She's pretty drunk. They don't seem to have much contact, but she tried to reach out.
Bill. Wait up. I'm meeting Susan and Heather tonight. Won't come?
Not today. Got things to do.
Are you sure? Susan really seems to like you.
Yeah, wish I could say the same.
Ooh.
I'll see you later.
Take it, I said.
No, take more of this. I can't get better for you. It doesn't work like that. I don't have your kind of strength.
What makes you think that I'm so strong?
You want me to get better? I want to, too. But it is not working.
or is it?
I know her.
Bill. That's my professor's daughter. How do you know her?
You, keep in contact with him?
Ran into him just recently, in the hospital. You were there.
Why? I want to know what became of her.
Oh. You knew her as kids?
Yeah, sort of. I'd say I have a long-lasting memory of her.
Wow, it's quite a coincidence. I'll ask him. Leon's excited about the fact that you knew his daughter's children. Hopes you guys can reconnect. Wow. You're not as excited as Leon about reconnecting. Well, good luck.
Thanks, Danny.
Damn. I want to apologize. Please, wait a moment. Wait. I really appreciate what you're trying to do for me. I'm not ready and I feel pressured and it doesn't help.
When you left and I never heard from you, I wiped you completely out of my mind. I've learned how to lose people. But when you came back, it was sort of a shock. You changed so much. I didn't recognize the girl that I used to know. I wanted the old Leah back. But now, more importantly, now, I don't want to lose you again.
Bill!
What are you doing?
She fell. I'm helping her.
Mom! Mom!
Okay, here. Put that on there. Hold it. Big kid. I'm gonna put a bandage on it, okay? Alright.
Alright, just hold that there.
2 seconds.
Is that better?
Yeah.
You want to go on an adventure?
Yeah.
Yeah? All right, we have to go.
I want to stay here. Can I take them?
No, they belong to someone.
Just one? Please?
Fine, just one, but we have to go.
Can we come back tomorrow?
Sure.
Ariel, I was just thinking about you.
Mom's in the hospital. Didn't they call you?
No, what happened?
I think it's serious this time. You need to go up there.
Well, what did they say?
Heart failure. Look, I know it's the last thing you want to do, but I really don't have money for a flight right now.
All right, text me the address and the phone number of the hospital.
How's the record coming along?
Have you listened to the track I sent you?
It's good.
Pieces. Do you want her? She's not as pretty and perfect as your doll.
Patricia, Jamie's mother, called me. She said that the jaw was between 40 and 50 years old.
I still need to find Belle.
Since when are we sharing?
Dad, I'm sorry.
Sorry, my ass. But who's paying for the booze? And where's my gun? I come out here to get a beer. No beer. Huh? Where is my gun?
Mom, help me, Mom, please.
Mom.
Ariel.
She's in LA.
It's so good to see you. It's been a very long time.
So what happened?
I collapsed at work.
Were you drunk?
There was a girl who came by looking for you.
What did she want?
She didn't say.
Well, does she have a name?
I think her name was Leah. I'm sorry, Billy.
It's okay, Mom. I don't want to talk about it. It's all in the past. I'll come back tomorrow. I'll stay at your place if that's okay.
The keys are in my purse.
See you tomorrow.
Hello? Mrs. McKenzie?
I know who you are.
I was actually looking for you.
I heard. Very late, though.
Yes, I know.
You know what? Save your breath. You know, you've got some nerve showing up here 12 years later. I mean, what kind of kid does that, huh? What kind of kid leaves another kid in a shaft? So why are you here, huh? Why now? You've done enough already. You want my forgiveness?
Please, let me explain.
I don't want to hear it. I can't. Just leave.
Thanks, Sam. For everything.
You're doing the best you can.
is this your parents' place?
No. They don't live here anymore.
I could do this for hours. And anything was better than being at home.
I was so scared. I could hear you calling and then you were gone.
I went to your house to try and tell your mother, but she didn't listen. We were leaving that night to move to Houston, and I tried to tell my parents, but they didn't believe me. They insisted it was my imagination. And after we moved, I got messed up and confused, and I just blocked it out of my mind. It wasn't until I came here a few days ago that I remembered what happened. I thought I had killed you. I know you must think I'm a coward. I'm sorry. How did you get out?
The dog. A dog appeared out of nowhere and he let me out.
Why did you hide the ladder?
It was a prank. It was a childish prank. I mean, I had no idea you were leaving that night. I guess I just... I wanted you to be aware of me. I mean, you seem so free and...
Did I shoot you?
My father was furious. I lost his gun.
Where's my gun? I know you took it. Where is it? Talk!
Stop, Frank! You're killing him!
Can we take this out?
Sure.
Parenting wasn't their strength. Most of the time they were wasted anyway.
morning after I got out of the mine, our family totally collapsed.
To go look for the gun.
I found the gun and he made me promise that I would never touch a gun again. Ever. And then he sat down and told me to go on ahead. And that was the last time I ever saw him. He left us that day.
You never looked for him?
I don't think he wanted to be found.
Why do you think that?
I think he killed himself.
When I was looking for you, I went down in the mine. There were human remains there.
Next one.
My dad had just finished a tour of Iraq. His last one. He wasn't always a senseless drunk.
Hey, Dad. Can we go swimming?
There you.
Okay.